Everyone, my name is D'Angelo, aka Darth Mexican from The Geek Life, and today I'm here with one third of the wonderful content creators from YouTube called Mega64.
Let's go a little more than that. Almost three thirds. When it comes to who carries the weight, who carries the importance and the authority, it's almost 100% of Mega64 right here. The remaining 2%. They're trying to find this place, but, you know, that's me. I'm on top of it. I got all the maps inside here, the knowledge.
That's true.
So, you know, I'm always on time and prompt. And proof is in the pudding. I'm here. I'm going to tell you how I made my billions. They're going to show up late and tell you how they dig in the dumpster for a peach pit.
We're excited for that.
Yeah.
All right, so our first question is, although I've been a fan of yours for quite a while, there might be some readers or viewers who haven't really seen your work before. Would you be okay introducing yourself and tell us a little about yourself?
Yeah, Mega64 is, we are a group that makes, we make a lot of kind of comedy videos or short films, whatever you want to call them, centered around the world of video games. And the kind of the most, the first thing we ever did was we took the concepts from video games and kind of put them in real life, like more kind of social things that we didn't think would be acceptable if you actually did them in real life that are just normal in a video game. So, you know, we did videos like that. And then, you know, we do a lot of other videos now too that kind of just poke fun or reflect strange things about the video game industry, you know, so we kind of, it's that, but then sometimes we just make short films that are weird because we want to do it. You know, we just, you know, we're a collective of short film making guys.
Right on.
Yeah. It's not a very good description, but
it's all good. All you need to know is they're wonderful in every way. That's
thank you. I appreciate it. Thank you.
Of course.
We have a podcast too. We do a podcast as well.
Oh, really? What's the podcast?
The Mega 64 podcast. We covertly say, we tell everyone it's the number one gaming podcast on the internet, which I think is true. Just numbers wise, but we talk about a lot of other, it just goes off the rails. And every year for Christmas, we have an eating competition to see who can eat the most, you know, shrimp.
Oh, very nice. Who was last year's winner?
Well, I'm always the winner.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm always the winner and still champion. Mm. So watch me, I ate a jar of mayonnaise. Proud stuff. If Derek was here, he'd be sad that I brought this up in a professional interview.
Oh, I see.
So,
And then, how long have you been creating incredible content, and what led you down this path? Like, were you guys all friends even before this, or did you have, like, one direction you wanted to go in, and then it just, like, spilled into multiple other directions?
We were, the three of us, the kind of main core group is me, Derek, and Sean. We all knew each other in high school, and we did theater together. And when high school ended, we were like, man, we were like creative and like doing plays and stuff together. Sometimes we'd make videos backstage, mm-hmm. making fun of other people in the plays and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. And we thought, well, let's do that some more. All right, I'm sorry. This is embarrassing. This is really, okay.
What's going on here?
Hey, you said you'd wait for us.
No unauthorized interviews. Was he trying to give all the answers by himself?
I'm trying to just kind of showcase, you know, basically who fulfills what role.
Okay, what did you say?
And I'm showing. I said film is a collaborative medium.
Okay.
And I couldn't do it without these guys. Respect. Who
did,
basically.
Did he really say that? Confirmation?
Yeah. They are
around the room?
We'll get our
almost,
view of the tape.
Okay, all right.
They are like, I'm like the 1% of Mega 64 down on the bottom. Oh, these guys do so much, and I couldn't be more proud
so humble,
have these friends. So thank you.
Yeah,
I just want to say
thank
you.
We're like the 99% doing all the work, getting none of the money. Okay.
Well.
Anyways, glad to have joined the interview.
Yeah, welcome.
We are joining the interview. So yeah, we started. We just wanted to make fun videos, and it just seemed like video games was kind of an interesting avenue. So that's what we did, and it goes to show you can do it if you want to make cool videos with your friends.
Yeah.
It seems like climbing mountains to get your, you know, hey, let's get all together and do that.
Yeah.
You can do it. Call them up. Hey, let's make a cool video this week.
Right.
You can do it. It seems impossible,
mm-hmm.
but you can do it. We were all lazy, and we still did it.
We all had humble beginnings.
We had humble beginnings. We sucked, and now look at us.
We were awful.
The number one content on the internet.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yes.
And by the numbers.
Yeah, of course.
And you guys had said that you were in theater when you were in high school. After high school, did you try any like sort of acting classes or any local theaters to help you guys improve in sort of like acting, or did you just go for it for your videos and learn?
We watched videos of ourselves and we said we can't get any better.
We mastered the craft. We had one friend, he's not with us for this interview, Garrett. He's the only one who took an acting class, and he literally took one class and then quit because he said he mastered it.
That's a true story. That's not a joke.
And we asked him, what do you mean? He's like, I did a monologue from a movie I already seen, and I did it exactly how they did it in the movie, so I mastered it. He mastered acting in one class.
That's true.
That's good.
We were lucky to have
Anthony Hopkins didn't do that.
We were lucky have an actor like that join our crew. You're not going to get somebody that good, but you can still make good videos.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. We knew once we had him in our arsenal. Like, you know, can't get better.
It was just all from there. Yeah. All right. So you guys had a really, really great career. And it's still growing and everything and getting better and better. But what would you say your favorite moment from everything was? Was it something in the beginning, or was it something more towards like current times that you would say?
Do you know? Do you guys have an answer?
I have one. I mean, there's several, but like, you know, we filmed a video for the Game Developers Conference back in 2007. And we got Shigeru Miyamoto to be in our video.
Oh, wow.
Which is really cool.
Yeah.
And so it was just us filming it. And just like when we watched the video with the crowd and like the huge reaction, it was like 1,000 people, more than that, like 5,000 people watching it.
Yeah.
And it was just like the best feeling. Just like, man, we filmed this video with the guy who made Mario. That's so awesome.
That's what I was literally going to say, this exact same moment. Because that's the only time we ever got a standing ovation.
Yeah.
That will never happen again.
That will never happen again. End of the road. It probably shouldn't have happened that time. Yeah. We got it, so that felt really good.
Yeah. For me, it was that, but also 2 years ago, we did a video with Hironobu Sakaguchi, who created Final Fantasy, and he got the Lifetime Achievement Award at the Game Developers Conference, and at the end of his speech, thanked Mega64.
That's true.
That was the last thing in his speech. I've played Final Fantasy. My whole family played Final Fantasy my whole life, and it was just like it all flashed before my eyes when that happened. It was like
put us in there.
That was incredible. I could have died at that moment. I think maybe I did. I don't know if I'm here. Check the tapes when this is over.
Yeah, and then the new Final Fantasy is like young dudes running around in public.
Right. Yeah, that's three. Wait, four.
Four.
Well, yeah. Okay.
Garrett. We have a fourth member, so it's just our life story, basically. So
yeah,
it's a tribute. Based to
us. It on us. There you go.
Another huge honor how they based Final Fantasy 15 off of our lives.
It's a shame. It's weird how graphically it couldn't make them as hot as us. But
They tried.
Yeah.
It's true.
Bummer.
Yeah.
It's hard to replicate perfection.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh well.
Well, you can't.
Now we've talked about your favorite moment, but what has been one of your more frustrating ones? Has that like there been a huge project you've been working on, and then just like Adobe Premiere or whatever editing software just like failed on you guys, or did something just fall through?
I feel like worst moment in the history of
majority of the most frustrating moments for me comes when we finally are filming outside, like we got a location, we're filming, and then we like don't have like the tripod plate or an SD card or the little things like that sitting back hours. That just drives me insane. But for the most part, I feel like we've gotten better at that.
Well, for me personally, we filmed a skit one time. You can check it out. It's on YouTube. Dead Rising. We did a Dead Rising skit where Rocco went to a mall, and he was pretending to be Frank West. He was like pulling barricades around.
I barricaded people into a play area.
Yeah, he's like pulling benches and trash cans like through the mall behind him. It was so good. I forgot to hit record.
Oh.
And so it was like, yeah, we got it. Yeah. We walk out of the mall. It's like, let's check the footage. And I stop tape and it starts recording. And I just realized like, we're going to have to go back inside and do all of that.
And I see a lot of your videos, like security gets called and everything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And they did. Yeah. And so, we couldn't go back in. We had to leave and come back.
It was a quiet car ride home.
It really was. That video is a success, but there is a whole other successful video that will never be seen. And that's the video I forgot to record.
The lost footage,
Sad day.
Yes.
All right. So what geek medium would you say has been the biggest impact in your life and why? I assume it's like video games, but is there any other aspect like comic books or anime or novels or anything like that?
It's funny because, like, yeah, we are always around and in the presence of video games, but I feel like we get a lot of our idea. You know, it's like we kind of see what's going on in video games, but I feel like a lot of times it's stuff from movies that will actually prompt us to, because I mean, we don't make movies on the level of Star Wars or anything, but because we make shorts and we're actually filming stuff, I feel like we get inspired by movies that we just saw. Mm-hmm. You know, like, oh, I just saw this movie, The Conversation, and I really like this one shot. So we'll, even though that has nothing to do with the game per se, it'll make us do a certain shot a certain way.
Oh, so you mean like a
technical
point.
Or like, I just watched this one episode of The Sopranos, and I like this shot where they're running with the guy after someone gets shot. Mm-hmm. We should have that shot. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? Yeah. That's how I feel, but I don't know. I don't know what you think.
Yeah, well, I think just personally, as like a nerd medium, I was into The Simpsons as a kid.
Yeah.
And that's what nerded out about. Yeah. And the comedy of that show really, I feel like, was the biggest influence on me personally.
Yeah.
Sean was into The Simpsons, but not so much Rocco. So
I liked it, but I didn't watch it religiously like you guys. I don't think.
Yeah. I feel like you're more like Japanese shows.
Old Super Sentai shows and stuff like that. Yeah. All the like physical weird. Yeah.
That's what we were moments. Watching as kids. Perfect.
But The Simpsons do that too, where they just will reference like a shot from The Shining for no reason and just keep going. And we kind of, I guess, kind of adapted that
for our style. That's awesome. That's interesting to hear. Yeah. And then, all right, so this is kind of a silly question. You can choose one fictional character from any universe to come to our world and be your best friend for life. Who is it and why?
Fictional character to come
from
to our world?
Any cinematic universe.
Yep. So it could be Naruto, Harry Potter.
Yeah, Dumbledore.
Oh, true.
Would it really? That's yours.
Why not? He's like a nice grandpa. Why not? Who doesn't want that around?
You say Naruto, Harry Potter. I'm not going to pick any losers like them.
Yeah.
Let me think.
You are not basic, yeah.
Yeah, somebody cool. That's a good question.
I got one. The ultimate one.
Mm-hmm. I had to Dumbledore.
Michael Corleone, the Godfather. Oh, if you walk around with him at any event, people are going to go, okay, whatever they want, give it to him. Because they know it's his way. True. He's going to make you an offer you can't say no to. True.
All right. Any character from any cinematic universe to come and be my best friend?
Your friend.
Forrest Gump.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a good one.
Because everything will happen.
Wow. That's a good one.
That dude accomplished everything and didn't even have to be smart.
You're going to space. Yeah. You're going to be doing these weird things.
He was a millionaire. He survived wars.
Yep.
And he was dumb as hell. How did he do it?
Yeah. I wish that was me.
Yeah, I always feel like I'm not good enough to accomplish things. Like, I'm not smart enough or handsome enough. But that guy was an idiot. And he did everything.
And he even survived getting shot in the butt toss.
Yeah, super inspirational. True. Me and him would paint the town red.
Yep. All right, so a lot of times content creators, or anyone creative really, will hit that wall where they just, like, we'll just get writer's block. Mm-hmm. What happens when you guys encounter that, and what's your method of actually dealing with it? Is it just, like, pushing through or just stopping for a moment
Many
and taking
methods.
A break?
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Many
There's
methods.
One that we... Oh, go ahead.
I know the most important method.
Yeah.
This is a last resort. If you hit writer's block, if you're trying to come up with a video concept or an idea, if you can't quite get it together, it may not always work, but a great last resort is the Beatles method.
Beatles method.
The Beatles, when they were coming up with songs, would sometimes write a song title
first.
Oh, and then start laughing about it, chuckling about it. What would that song be? And then boom, they would make a song.
We're all huge Beatles fans, legitimately, and we watch the Beatles anthology, and there's a story about how they'd been playing all day. They didn't realize that the sun had gone down, and Ringo just went, oh, it's been a hard day, and they looked out the window. It's night.
There you go.
Then they wrote Hard Day's Night.
Boom.
There you go.
So if it worked for them, it sounds silly, but if it worked for the greatest band of all time, why couldn't it work for
We have a video the out there. We have a video out there, a holiday video called Clause and Effect.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That was written using the Beatles method.
What were you going to say?
I was going to say, we literally thought, let's make a video called Clause and Effect, and we put our pencils down, and we grabbed the cameras, and we ran with it.
Another one time somebody went up to the whiteboard and wrote, Portal Up My Ass. Mm-hmm. We didn't know what that meant, and it became a video called Portal Number 2, where someone had a portal in their ass. Mm-hmm. Right. So as you could see, we try to raise the bar, try to keep it classy,
Kings of comedy.
Respectful.
Yeah. And that's just one method, but you're going to have to pay for the rest.
Yeah.
And then these are the last two questions. So one of them is a very hard one that will divide your fan base. So do you prefer subbed anime or dubbed anime, if you watch anime? Yeah.
You're either with me or you're against me. Mm-hmm. Subtitles.
Thank you. You guys.
You know what? I enjoy them both for different reasons. Legitimately. I enjoy subtitles because I I'm a filmmaker, and I like presenting things the way they were intended originally to be made. I don't like director's cuts. I don't like when the studio messes with it. The creator had a vision, and I want to see his vision.
Exactly.
But I'm not a native Japanese speaker, and I like to introduce anime to other people, and sometimes reading is not people's forte, and it gets in the way of the story.
Piss on them. Leave them behind. No.
Leave them behind. And legitimately, you may not like to hear this. Sometimes the English dub is better.
Okay, now...
Sometimes it is.
I'll see you... I will say... I'm going to say never except Bebop.
Yeah, but you would never know that.
Bebop is okay.
You would never know which are better unless sometimes you listen to the dubs. So you got to experience it, okay? I always do subtitles first, and then if I really like it, I want to hear it in English. Mm. That's how I am.
I prefer it muted with no subtitles. I said to guess what's going on.
Oh, nice.
That's what
he's
I
a lip reader.
Cut that out.
Yeah. No, keep that in. No. It's revolutionary.
There you go.
No. And then the last question is, what piece of advice do you have for aspiring content creators? Now, usually when I ask this question, the response is always like, don't ever give up on your dreams and keep going forward. But what other
That's
piece of advice?
That's awful advice,
yeah,
by
give
the
up.
Way.
Give up. If, yeah.
That's awful advice.
What we always say is make sure your video is short. People don't know how to edit themselves, and a lot of times they want to show their friends a video.
Or leave in every funny part.
Right,
or
have a blooper reel. It's 15 minutes is not going to work. It needs to be 3 minutes or under, and you have to learn how to do that. Censoring yourself is very important. Mm-hmm. And, you know, go back to our old videos. It's like, oh, God, we should have cut forever ago if we just didn't do it. So, like, that's a hard lesson to learn, but that's a big one.
You know what? Can I change your viewers' lives right now? Can
go
I give
for
them
it.
A
yeah.
single piece of advice that's going to blow their minds? Mm-hmm. Blast through all your ideas this week. There are so many people out there who are like, someday I'm going to make a good video, and I have a good idea for this video, but someday.
Yeah.
And I have another idea, but that's going to come before the other video, but I'm not there yet. And they have kind of like these stepping stones until they start making the videos they really dream of making.
Yeah.
Either throw all those stepping stones away or get to it and do it this week. Because
otherwise someone else is going
to
do it.
Here's what's going to happen. If you don't get to it, somebody else will get to it. You're probably worried that your idea is not as good as you originally thought it was.
Yeah.
It's probably not. So just hurry up and get it out there and face reality. Your idea wasn't that great. And then once you've kind of cleared all the cobwebs out of your head, you've made room for all the really good ideas to come. And so many people never get started because they're just putting off like these ideas. Just do it.
Yeah.
All right?
Yeah. Just do it.
Turn this interview off right now and go do that idea you're holding off on doing. Just do it right now.
Mm. And then come back after you're done and hear this. Great job.
There you go. Yeah. Now on to the next one.
All right. So this was an amazing interview. I really enjoy talking with you guys and all that. Where can people find you? I know that you're on YouTube, but I know that you also guys have a website as well, right? Is it all under Unified Branding and everything?
Yes.
It's all Mega64. Yeah.
Okay. Mega64.com is the hub of all of it.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And we have a Twitch stream. We
and
have
not only that, I want to say we just recently launched a Patreon, which has been very successful. And we have the best Patreon on the internet.
Yeah.
Legitimately, most people's Patreons, they're awful.
They suck.
You give them money and they write you a fart joke and email it to you. Who cares? We have set up like a box full of exclusive merchandise that people can get. And it's kind of like a loot crate, but it's all Mega64 stuff. And there's exclusive videos that you, for just $1, you get extra content that is exclusive to the patrons. So check that out, patreon.com/mega64.
Our crate doesn't have Doctor Who stuff in it.
Yeah.
So we win.
Only stuff people like.
Sorry.
Popular stuff.
Sorry, Doctor.
Sorry.
It's an anime convention, so you're safe here.
Okay.
You
know.
Phew. All right, well, thank you guys again.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Very much.
And what was your name?
D'Angelo. From the
D'Angelo. Game. Sorry, I butted in halfway through. Now the interview's over.
Yeah. Thank you.